So what is going on, guys? Today we're going to be doing 5 megs that you can use in any game situation.
So if you guys aren't aware what a nutmeg is, you might be totally confused about this. It's basically where you beat an opponent by putting the ball through with their legs. Whether this is a defender, a keeper, whoever, it doesn't matter. It's a nutmeg. Whether it's your friends in the park, it really doesn't matter. Either way, I'm going to read out the actual definition. It might just be what I've said, but it's basically kicking the ball through an opponent's legs in order to pass them. It's basically just a dribbling skill. But there's many different ways on how to do this, and that's what I'm here to show you today. I'm going to only show you 5, but if you want to see more, let me know by leaving a like, comment, tell me on Twitter, all that sort of thing. But yeah, let's just get straight into the video. So the first one's super simple. You literally don't need to touch the ball for this one, but it's basically so useful. I've used this in the game, and I'm going to be honest, I'm not going to tell you if I haven't. I've used this about 4 or 5 times, I think, in the whole time I've played, just because it only pops up in certain situations when a defender is right on your back. So it works perfectly how I described it here, because Brad is right up on my back, so I can literally just let the ball go straight through both of our legs. He can't physically see the ball because my body's in the way, and I've put a little bit of emphasis on my movement so that he thinks I'm going to take it left or right, but really it's gone between his legs. I mean, you can't get more cheeky than that. It's quite nice to watch as well. I feel like it's a nice, beautiful skill. But yeah, like I said, there's not much practice to this. Try and be as enthusiastic as you can when you're either turning left or right, so they think you're going to go one direction, and make yourself look big, because then they cannot see the ball. That's the main aim. So they can't see the ball. They don't know what you're going to do with it, and that's the trickery around it. Let's move on. So I'm not sure exactly what this skill is called. I believe it's called the Sonic Turn, I think. I don't know. Maybe you guys have different names. I always get tortured in the comments for putting random names and stuff that you guys don't agree with. But either way, I'm going to call it the Sonic Turn. It's such a beautiful one to look at. I think it's one of the harder ones of the 5 to do. So it's going to take a little bit of practice. What you want to do is the ball's coming in. You want to try and chop it, like chopped behind your legs, as you can see. And then you want to turn your body on a 180 to push the ball through the legs. Now, it has to be quite quick, because if you try to do that on a defender, they've got a lot of chance to just stick their foot in. So the distance, the timing, everything is so important. But if you constantly practice this trick, you can practice off a wall, which is something that I would do. Kick the ball against the wall, practice it on nobody. But then if you've got a mate or you've got a defender in training or anything like that, then give it a go. I mean, training is where you want to try express yourself in skills and things. That's where I did. In match situations, you know, you kind of get the right time. You want to do it at the right time sometimes. But either way, like I say, I really, really like this one to look at, and I think it's really, really smooth. Give it a go. If you can't do it, keep practicing. Eventually you'll get it. All right, let's move on. Okay, for this one, it's not really used a lot in games. You won't find a lot of people using it. You will see it on the odd occasion. It's mainly more in the Brazilian and Spanish leagues. You'll see this just because of the way English football is. But either way, you can do this stationary. I've showed a couple of like examples where I've been stationary, which means I'm basically standing still when I'm doing the trick. But it can be done on the move. It's just there's different variations to it. Push it out first with my like the bottom of my foot, and then I drag it to the left, because that basically leads the defender in to think you're going to go forward. So they step with their foot, and then you drag it inside of them. That's basically why I like that one over just the drag. I mean, you can just drag it through people's legs. It will work if you put emphasis on your body, but put emphasis on your trick is the most important part of it. But either way, give us a shot. Let's move on to the next one. All right, so you've probably seen this trick used on my channel a lot. It's probably one of my favorite tricks to use in a game, in training, wherever. It's just such a beautiful skill. So basically with this one, you're going to drag it over your left foot or your right foot, depending on what strong foot you are. I'm right, so I go with my right foot, and then I flick through with my weak foot, just because then I can run on and touch it with the outside of my right foot and drag it away. This is just a trick that I use quite a lot, just because I think it just fools defenders every time. Like, if you're coming up to someone brand new who doesn't know you, because all my mates now know that I like that trick quite a lot and they know what's coming, but if you do it against someone brand new, they're just not going to have a clue, basically. They're just going to be stuck. But either way, it's just beautiful. Use this one, master it. Let's move on. All right, so this is a lot similar to the one that I've already shown with the inside of the foot, but it's with the outside of the foot. It's a lot different in a sense of how your body works. Now, if you notice, my head is up when I do this skill on one of the goes, because I'm trying to fake Brad into thinking I'm looking around to give a pass, to do something. And if you notice, I'll slow this down for you, because it's really quite clever. Even though it happens so fast, you might not realize it. I push the ball forward again, so he thinks that I'm going to go down line. Obviously, right now, it's just for an example. He knows exactly what I'm going to do. But in a game, if a defender sees you push it forward, he's going to, again, step that in front, just to try and get your foot on the ball, and then you're just going to drag it back through. And because you're not physically looking at him, you can pretend you don't even know he's coming in, which is the best point about it. If you fake the defender into thinking you're not even looking at him or don't know he's coming in, and you can just hear him, then it's perfect, because you make him look a mug. He can slip over. People can laugh or clap you. You know, it happens.
We'll be right back.
So I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Like I say, if you want to check out the other skills videos, they'll be on the screen somewhere else. Go subscribe as well. If you want to see 5 more megs, I could do that as well. If you want more detail on them, go on my Twitter, go down the comment section, ask me questions, at me in there, and I'll answer them. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you in a couple of days.